Hi, this is COMP1010 at the University of Manitoba. I'm Dr. Celine LaTulip, and in this video, I'll go through an example of using arrays in an active processing script. So the processing script that we're going to use is this bouncing ball script. And so we've used this bouncing ball example before in class. And in this bouncing ball script, what we have is a ball that bounces around the screen. So we draw a box on the screen. There's some constants that define the box. And we actually draw a ball that has a size diameter of 30. And it sort of starts in some initial position that's defined here. I'm going to scroll in so that you can see this well. And then we have a sort of a setup function where we define the box based on the size of our canvas. We set a background color. And then we have these draw functions where we draw the box, we calculate the position, and we draw the ball. And that will happen 60 times a second. So the draw box is here. It's pretty straightforward. The calculate position here, what we're doing is we're adding the x speed to the ball x position, the y speed to the ball y position. And then in order to make the ball bounce off the sides, we have to see if we've got the ball hitting the bottom or the top. We reverse the ball speed in the y direction. If we've got the ball hitting the left or the right, we reverse the ball speed in the x direction. And then when we draw the ball, we just use the ball color and draw the ball at x and y using the ball size. So we can run this just to see how it looks. And here's our bouncing ball. So in this example, what we'd like to do is use arrays to actually create a whole bunch of bouncing balls, not just one. So that's what we're going to do here. So what we need to do is create arrays that hold a bunch of information about the balls. So we're going to sort of change this code. We're going to modify it. So we're going to have all the balls be the same size. So this constant can stay the same. But now we're going to modify these be arrays. And so what we're going to do is we're going to say this ball X needs to be an array of a bunch of balls. And also we're going to have to decide how many balls we want. So let's create a constant for that. Final int num balls. And let's say we want 10. Okay. So now what we're going to do is ball X is actually going to be a reference pointer to an array of floats. So we're going to change this to be new float. And the number of X positions we need is the number of balls. So num balls. And then we're going to comment that out. So we initialized the original ball X to just some random value. And so what we're going to do now is in setup, we are going to go through this array and put a bunch of random values in it. So let's go down here into our setup and we're going to create a for loop. We're going to say int I equals 0, I is less than numballs, I plus plus. Okay. And then ball x of I is going to get a random value. So we want it to be somewhere between 0 and width, so we can just do random width. And we've made this an array of floats, and random returns a float, so that'll be fine. And then now we are getting a whole bunch of random starting X positions. So that's good. So now we want to do the same thing with ball Y. And so what we do here is we say new float and num balls. Okay, and again, we need to actually assign some values here. So ball y equals random, and this time we want it to be between 0 and height. So we'll just do height. Okay, so now we've got random x positions. Now, we also maybe want them all to be different colors. So we can set up an array of colors here. So ball color, and here we want new color num balls. And we're going to then, in our setup, we're going to randomly assign a color. So this looked like that. I'm going to copy that down here. So ball color of I equals, and that looked like this. But what we actually really want here is random of 255 and random 255 and random 255. Okay. Oops. Typo. There we go. All right. So now we have starting XY positions for our 10 balls. Each one is going to get assigned a random color. And now we could say, do we want the balls to move at different speeds? Well, we might. So let's create some different speeds here. So int ball x, ball speed x, we're going to have an array of them. So each ball can have its own speed. So now we'll say new int. And same for the y. So this will be new int. And oops, we have an error here because, of course, I haven't said how many slots. And of course, this has to be the same, numballs and numballs. Okay, good. So now in here, we have to create random speeds. So ball speed x of I is going to be, so let's make these random between, we want the ball speeds to be, we don't want them to be too slow. So maybe between 2 and 5 in the x direction. Now, ball speed x is an int. So what we want to do is get this number and then cast it to an int. Okay. And the same for ball speed y. And we'll make the y also be random between 2 and 5. And that should be, some of them are going to be fast, some of them are going to be slow, some of them are going to be fast in the y direction and slower in the x direction. So this should look kind of interesting. Okay, so this gives us all of our setup. Now in draw, we actually need, not in draw, in our calculate position, we're going to have to update the code. And you can see now, if we move down to calculate position, this is just all marked as red, like, ah. And if we click on this first one, just the ball x plus equals the ball speed, we'll say the operator is undefined for the arguments of type float and int array, float array and int array. So this is the name of our array, and this is the name of our array. And what we want is we want values out of our array. So what we're going to want to do is every time we calculate position, we're going to want to calculate it for all 10 of the balls. So all of this is going to have to go into a big for loop. So we're going to create exactly the same structure for loop. For int I equals 0, I is less than the number of balls, I plus plus. And we're going to, everything that's in here is going to go in this for loop. And we're going to, I'm going to hit Command T on my Mac to make this indent nicely. And for each of these things inside the for loop, we now have to change it not to be access, not to be using the array name, but to be accessing an element of the array. So all we're going to be doing is adding this square bracket I to basically every reference variable name in here. So this will get, and you can see now just with this one, we're getting the x position at of ball x, the one that's in slot I. So the first one, we're getting the x speed, and we're adding it and placing it back in. So that's going to change. Here, we're getting the y position for the ball at this index. And we're adding the y speed to that and then storing it back in the ball y at that index. So similarly here, we need to put in the same thing here. So box bottom is our constant that's, or our variable that talks about where the bottom of the box is. So we don't need anything there, but ball y is our array. And then we need the same thing here. Ball speed y is going to get, is going to be reversed from its old position for this ball. And so we do the same thing here. So these are all arrays. There we go. Okay. So now in our drawing, we want to fill with ball color. Ball color is an array. So, and the ellipse, ball X and ball Y, these are arrays. So again, we're, iterating through the balls to update the calculations, we also need to iterate through and to do the drawing. So again, we're going to have our same for loop for int I equals zero, I less than numballs, I plus plus, and we'll indent that nicely. And now we can use our indexing of I. So in here, what this is going to do is say, let's get the color that we want for this ball from the ball color array, and then let's get the x and y coordinates that have been calculated up here for this ball, and using this color and these x and y coordinates, we're going to draw the ball, and ball size doesn't change. It's the same for all the balls. Okay, so hopefully that all works. Let's run it and have a look. Okay, so we've got some issues because these balls are not being handled appropriately in terms of where they are going. So let's have a look at our code and see what the issue is. So if ball y is greater than box bottom minus the ball size, or if ball y is greater less than the box top minus the size, we want to reverse the speed. So I have a feeling that what we want is to have negative 1 times this, because what we're doing here is we're trying to make negative of an array index. So negative 1 times, and let's stop and try that again. And so that's looking a little bit better. We're getting most of our balls are actually bouncing around in here, but not quite all of them. So let's make sure that we are setting our initial balls. These balls out here are initially set outside of our range, and so I think that's the problem. So we want our ball X's to be actually inside of box left and box right and so on. So we'll close this. So in here where we're initially setting up our balls, we just said give us anything. But if the ball is outside of the box, then we're going to have problems. So let's change this to be the random of box left and then box right. And random of box top and box bottom. Okay, and then we'll try that. All right, here we go. So now we have all of our balls are initially inside the box and they are all bouncing around at all sorts of different speeds. They're all different colors. And this is using basically 5 arrays, one array for the X coordinate, one array for the Y coordinate, one array for the color of the ball, one array for the current X speed of the ball, and one array for the current Y speed of the ball. And these numbers are just changing back and forth between negative and positive once they're set. So ball speed X, if it was set at 3, it would just always be 3 or negative 3 when it needed to bounce in the other direction. Okay, so hope that example shows you how you might use arrays to do a bunch of things and keep it fairly, the code still fairly simple. This code does not look very different from the original code, except that we have arrays of values now, and we have to add for loops to iterate through the arrays to update and to draw and to set up. Okay, thanks for watching.